Toronto has got a raging case of Raptors fever. Outside the team store in Scotiabank Arena, fans lined up waiting to score gear in Raptor red, silver, and black. In a country where hockey has long ruled, right now, basketball is king.
It's an unprecedented level of excitement. The NBA has always had its constituency here. What you're seeing is the popularity of the sport and the popularity of this team from a spectator standpoint going beyond the core constituency and going fully mainstream.
With a diverse roster of many ethnicities, the Raptors mirror the city they play in. Freddie and Mildred Manila came to Canada from the Philippines.
Having this kind of thing is something that's brought Canada together.
Kiran Raju's parents immigrated from India.
It's nice to see, you know, Indians, Chinese people, North Americans, Europeans, Latinos, everybody coming together around one game and one behind one flag, actually. So,
Sportsnet 590 The Fan, can I get your name and where you're calling from?
Rob Wong hosts a popular sports radio call-in show.
A lot of immigrants that come to this country, they take to the sport of basketball, and it's such a global sport as well, so I think that adds to it. So it really speaks to the city of Toronto because of how multicultural we are, and it speaks to the country of Canada as well because it's very much the same.
For people here, just getting this close to victory has been a long time coming.
Toronto is a sports-mad city, but it hasn't had a championship in baseball, basketball, or hockey for over 20 years. So the Raptors' wild ride has created a sense of euphoria here.
Some fans have high hopes of Canada beating its giant southern neighbor.
Feels amazing to finally get one over the U.S., if you want to call it that, so it feels good.
A diverse city and country waiting for an elusive championship. Rob Reynolds, Aljazeera, Toronto.